Hello everyone, Namaskar. Welcome to today's session. So today we will be covering the reasons for late marriage. What are the yog that are there in the chart which we should be looking for to see if there is a late marriage promised in the chart or not. So having gone through so many charts, I have gathered some of the experience on this and I'll be sharing that with you today. So without any further delay, let's get started. So the major planet which actually signifies delay in the marriage is Saturn. So if you see any association of Saturn with the 7th house, 7th lord, or with Venus, which is the karak of marriage in the chart, Dara Karaka according to Gemini astrology, which is the planet with the lowest degree, and also if it is conjoined with the 7th lord of D1 in the D9. So suppose if you have Aries ascendant and you have 7th lord Venus. So if your Venus and Saturn are together in the Navmansha, then that is also a reason for late marriage. So just skim through all of these. So first of all, placement of Saturn in the 7th house, or if it is aspecting the 7th house, then its association with 7th lord, that means conjunction or aspect. Then if it becomes the 7th lord, then it is also one of the reasons. That is not the only reasons, but again you should be also looking at where is the placement of Saturn, where it is actually placed, and what is its placement in Navmansha. That mainly signifies, because being the 7th lord doesn't always promise that it will be a late marriage. But then again, if it is poorly placed or if it has some kind of affliction, then it becomes quite prominent chance. It becomes a prominent chance that it is quite likely that marriage will be delayed. Then aspect on the Venus. Now you know that in Vedic astrology, Venus is considered to be the planet which signifies marriage. So for that reason, you need to check the placement of Venus, and if it is having any association, any aspect from the Saturn, if that is happening, then chances of late marriage is again there. Now placement of if it is placed in the 7th house of Navmansha, then if it is conjoined with 7th lord of D1 in D9. So these are the conditions. Let us go through some of the case studies that we have and let us try to figure out why marriage was delayed in this charts. So let us move on to our first case study. So here if you see, this is a chart of Libra ascendant, and here we have Saturn placed in the sign of Capricorn. And in the sign of Capricorn here, from this sign, it is aspecting the Venus. So Venus is placed in the 6th house, which is not actually the house of delay, but again it is the 8th lord. Now, and Saturn is aspecting the Venus. So Venus here is exalted, it is getting aspected by Jupiter, but at the same time Saturn is also aspecting it. And the placement of Venus is in the 6th house, which shows a bit of unconventionality in the marriage or the way the marriage will proceed. And because Saturn is also aspecting the Venus, it also signifies that there should be some kind of a delay in marriage. And that is what is happening. The person was born in 1993 and she is not expecting to actually get married at least in next 2-3 years. So this was one. Let us move on to second case study. So this is the chart of a person who was born in 1992 and she is yet to marry. And if you check the chart, here we have Saturn placed in the 10th house, it is aspecting the 7th house. Now here Sun is also debilitated in the 7th house. Now this is also one of the yoga. If your 7th house is ill placed or it is having some kind of affliction, or if any debilitated planet is placed in the 7th house, it causes some kind of unconventional approach towards the marriage. It also could result into delay. It also could lead into multiple relationships, multiple failed relationships if you have some debilitated planet in the 7th house. Here in this case, if you look at the chart, so here we have Saturn aspecting the 7th house. Here's Sun is debilitated, and this Saturn is aspecting the debilitated Sun. So what happens is the ego of that person is quite fragile. Her ego gets hurt on every small and petty issues, and for which she breaks her every relation. So a relation continues for a year or so, and then she breaks that relationship. So that is where the issue is from the chart. And because Saturn is also aspecting it, it will get aggravated over the time. Now Saturn has moved into Capricorn recently, as you all know, and it will be aspecting the sign of Libra. So this will actually trigger the marriage for the native, and also the native will be going through the Sun Dasha, will be soon entering into her Sun Dasha in a year, and which also shows that because the planet is placed in the seventh house, it will also trigger the events related to seventh house, which shows marriage. So in all aspect, it shows that yeah, chances are pretty high that the person will marry in couple of years. So by that, if considering that, by that time the person would have turned 29, 30, and if you consider in Indian subcontinent, a female is getting married at the age of 29 or 30 is considered to be a late marriage. Moving on, just one more thing. If you also see, seventh lord is Venus, and Venus is placed in the eighth house. Eighth house also signifies delay, obstacles, and hardship in life. So in a way, here also we can see that there is some relation between the two. Also, if you see the Navamancha chart, the seventh lord Venus is getting aspected by Saturn. So here Saturn and Venus relation is also there, which also promises that there will be a chance of late marriage. Moving on to our third case study. So here we have a native with Cancer ascendant, and she has a seventh house as Capricorn. And now if you see, the Lord of Capricorn, Saturn, is placed in the sixth house, so which shows that there would be a connection between the sixth house and the seventh house. So sixth house, what it is actually, it is about your profession, where you work, about all your commitment that you put into your employment. So mainly a house which links to your employment. And here we have seventh lord getting into the house of employment, which shows that somewhere she might find her spouse in the work organization, or in the organization where she's working, or something related to that sort. So, and again, if you see, the seventh lord happens to be Saturn. If you move on to Navamancha, here also you see that seventh lord happens to be Saturn here also, and the eighth lord Jupiter is aspecting the Saturn. So here also there is a high chance of having late or delayed marriage. And also if you see, there is a Pap Katri Yoga in the seventh house. So on the either side we have Saturn and Rahu placed, and both are the planet which delays things quite further. So here is also a yoga which signifies that yeah, marriage will be delayed. Now if you see, if I have to narrow it down to the timing of marriage, so here is one chance when Saturn, Jupiter, and many of the planets will be placed in her seventh house, will be transiting over into seventh house. This will happen in 2020 and early 2021. So this shows that there is a high possibility of her getting some marriage proposal around in 20, late 2020 or early 2021. And after that, when Saturn gets into the sign of Aquarius, she will be entering into Shani ki Dhaiya. So Shani will be transiting eighth from the moon, which will trigger some kind of an event in her life. So whenever Saturn transit 8th from the moon, it actually creates a kind of havoc in your mind, because there are some events that have recently happened, because of which many things get triggered in your life. So chances of getting married, there are two phases actually. One is towards the late 2020 and early 2021, and after that, when Saturn is just about to enter the sign of Aquarius. As because Saturn will be transiting 8th from the moon, it will create a lot of mental issues, hurdles, disturbance, and possibly just before that, it might also cause a kind of event which might trigger that. So the major change could be marriage, and so these are the two phases that where marriage looks quite possible. Anyway, if I consider the age of the native, she was born in 1989, and so by now she will be 31, and which is obviously considered to be a late, quite a late age for marriage in Indian subcontinent. Coming on to fourth case study, here we have. So if I go through this chart, I don't see any reason for late marriage. See, if you see the seventh house, moon is placed in the seventh house, which shows that chances of getting marriage proposals quite early, at a quite early age, is quite likely. Also, it shows that because there is a aspect, mutual aspect between Mars and moon, it also shows that there are chances that the person might have a multiple relationship. Also, the reason being, these two combination are placed in dual sign. So Mars is placed in a dual sign, Moon is placed in dual sign, and also there is a mutual aspect between the two. So which shows that there are also chances that the person might have been in multiple relationship at the same time. And if you look at the seventh lord, it is Jupiter. It is not getting aspected by any planet, and it is pretty well placed, although forming Kendra Adipati dosh. But then fourth house for Jupiter is considered to be a very good house because in Kalpurush Kundli, Jupiter is exalted in Cancer. So this is considered to be a very good house. But then if you go move on to Navmansha, here we have Saturn placed in the seventh house. So there is the major issue with the placement of Saturn, so which causes delay in marriage. For this native, she was born in 1992, and I have predicted that only towards the end of 2022 or early 2023 she will have a chance to get married, not before that. Now coming on to next series, so if we have eighth lord affecting our seventh house or seventh lord, this is also one of the chance of having late marriage. So let us go through some of the cases. First of all, just let us skim through all the conditions that we have. So placement of eighth lord in the seventh house, then any association with seventh lord, either by aspect or by conjunction. Eighth lord of Navmansha conjoined with seventh lord of Navmansha. So if that happens in the Navmansha chart, then also there are chances that marriage will be delayed. And then conjoined with the seventh lord of D1 in D9. So suppose if I have Aries ascendant and I have my seventh lord as Venus and eighth lord as Mars. So both of them, if they are placed together in the sign in the Navmansha, then there are also chances that marriage will be delayed, because eighth house or eighth lord is considered to be house of obstacle, house of delay, and which actually takes a very long time to complete even the most simplest of things. So let us go through some of the examples. Here in this chart, if you see, here we have seventh lord Mars and eighth lord Venus placed together. Now, because you can see that Saturn is placed in sign of Sagittarius, so it is obvious that the person will be born before 1990. So this native was born in 1989. He's around 31 at the moment, and he's yet to marry. So here the main reason for delay is, first of all, your seventh lord is getting aspected by Saturn. Your seventh lord is placed with Venus, and both of them are getting aspected by Saturn. So this it itself shows that marriage will be pretty delayed in this case. Now moving on to second case study. If you remember, we told you we have talked about Dharakaraka. So Dharakaraka, if it is getting aspected or has any relation with Saturn, that is also one of the reason for delayed marriage. So this native was born in 1990 and she just got married in 2019. So at the age of 29, she got married. Now, if you see, the planet with the lowest degree here in this chart is Moon. So Moon is around 0 degree, and according to Gemini astrology, it is considered to be Dharakarak, the planet with the lowest degree. Now, if I consider the Gemini aspect, so in Gemini aspect, what happens is a dual sign aspects the other dual sign. So if this is Virgo, so Virgo will be getting aspect or will be aspecting all the dual signs like Sagittarius, Pisces, and Gemini. So there will be a relation between Moon and Saturn as in the Gemini aspect. And also, if I consider the Parashari astrology, even according to that, Saturn will be aspecting the Moon, the Dharakarak. So again, there is a chance, or there is a prominent chance of delayed marriage. Also, if you see this, there is a conjunction of 7th Lord and 8th Lord. So the 8th Lord Mercury is placed in the 7th house with the 7th Lord. So though this conjunction is not very tight, so Sun is of 5 degree, Mercury has almost left the sign and it is around 29 degree. But again, this is also one of the reasons why marriage has been delayed. So these are all case studies. Let us move on to some other reasons why a marriage could be delayed. So if there is any association of Rahu and Ketu, so these are not actually, this shouldn't be treated as the major reason for the delay in marriage. Rahu Ketu actually are the planet which causes things to be unconventional, unusual. For suppose if a person has multiple relationship, is dating many people at the same time, or you can say that a person is dating or getting married with someone of outer caste, that could be a reason. And Ketu mainly shows detachment. So if Ketu is associated with any of the mentioned planets or houses, what it does, it actually detaches you from that house and causes a bit of separation, which is also a reason, which could be also one of the reasons for delay. So this is one thing that you need to see, apart from many other things. So for what reason that delay happened, this could be more of a reason which added to the delay of marriage, couldn't be the actual reason for the delay, but this could just add up to the delay. So the intensity might not be same as the impact of Saturn, which creates the delay in the marriage, but yeah, you can feel the, or you can sense the impact of these planets if there is something unusual related to marriage that has happened in their life. So association of Rahu and Ketu with 7th house or the 7th Lord or Venus or Dharakaraka, or involvement of them with the 7th Lord in the D9. So these are some of the reasons why marriage is delayed because of Rahu and Ketu. So for today, that's it. This is from my side. So hope I was able to explain all with all the case study pretty well, that what could be the reason for delay in the marriage. Hope I was able to clarify things pretty well. See you in the next session. Thanks for joining. Do give the video a big thumbs up and do subscribe to the channel.